In Stow, Ohio, lies a prehistoric site which archaeologists have dated ranging anywhere from 300 to possibly 8,000 years ago. Nearly an equal distance from the Chevy dealership, the CVS, and the Stow Cone, it's the most polluted and botched archaeological site we've ever visited. Let's take a look. We first became aware of the Stow Rockshelter, just beneath the intersection of Kent and Darrow Road, by reading Caves and Culture, 10,000 Years of Ohio History, written by, among others, Dr. Olaf H. Prüfer. Dr. Prüfer was described by one of his former students at Kent State as having, this person's words, not mine, breath of overwhelmingly alcohol. So there that is. But if you search his name, there's plenty of WordPress tribute posts. They're interesting to read. He also earned his bachelor's, master's, and doctorate from Harvard University. Afterwards, he was briefly the curator of anthropology for the Cleveland Museum of Natural History, while also a professor of anthropology at Case Western. Then it appears he was demoted to assistant professor for a number of years before landing at Kent State University in 1968. Anyway, in the book he gives excellent directions to the archaeological site, known as the Stow Rock Shelter. Easy to spot thanks to the very large and gaudy art installation in the parking lot. It's a short hike down the valley and upstream. Here's how you can get there. Adele Durbin Park is located at 3300 Darrow Road in Stow. Behind the parking lot, it shows three trails labeled as red, blue, and yellow arrows. If you follow the blue trail down the steps into the gorge, it takes a fair amount of scrambling up the creek, over fallen trees, and across the rocks until you reach the rock shelter. Along the way, you'll spot on the east side of the gorge an abandoned ledge deck that's falling apart next to an outcropping of Sharon conglomerate along the ridge. Besides that, it's mostly pollution and garbage, so just watch where you step. The first sign that you've reached the site are the piles of dirt just below the rock shelter. As you approach it, it becomes evident that people are still digging here. The open excavation pits with construction netting strewn about makes for a jarring experience. To continue a bit further into the gorge, the smell of pollutants becomes overwhelming. If you were able to magically remove all the trash and the awful smell, this little section of Walnut Creek would be the picturesque and absolutely beautiful. So what the hell's going on at Stow Rock Shelter? What do we know? Let's start at the beginning. Prüfer wrote regarding the history of the rock shelter, "Local lore has it that it was used by picnickers and hobos. The earliest investigations at the site were conducted by David G. Mitten in 1952 when he was a high school student mentored and inspired by one of Ohio's archaeological legends, the late Arthur George Smith, whom Prüfer knew well. In fact, Smith launched Mitten on a distinguished career in Old World archaeology. He is presently Hanfman Curator of Ancient Art at Harvard University. At this time, Mitten explored Stow Rock Shelter with two local individuals, James Cross and his son Larry, now of Arizona. The finds ended up in Cross's possession after they were published by Mitten in the Ohio Archaeologist, 1955. Then, in 1955, Charles Sofsky spent 3 months in the winter excavating the shelter. He was quoted as saying on tape that, quote, "The site had been so badly disturbed, and they were finding broken pot shards and broken arrowheads. Somebody, I know the fellow that was in there, but I'm not going to mention his name. But he was from Stow, and he wasn't one of us. He ended up being an archaeologist in the Mideast doing classic archaeology. Anyway, he had been in there and potholed the living daylights out of it," end quote, referring to David Mitten. The site was forgotten about until 1998. Other than an incident where some Kent State University students carelessly dumped flint chippage from Coshocton in the rock shelter in 1969, effectively contaminating the site. Today, the Stow Rock Shelter is still being investigated, according to Kent State University. Although it appears that nothing further has been published, Kent State's website references it, and Dr. Michelle Beber won a grant as recently as May of 2021 to continue excavating this site. Oddly enough, Kent's website states that, quote, "artifacts found date back to nearly 8,000 years ago," end quote, but all published material dates it firmly in the late woodland period. If you happen to know where the extra 7,700 years came from, please let me know in the comments.